Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mr. P with Mr. P Explores, and we are here today near Youngstown, Ohio, to check out what is left of the old Struthers switching yard, an old area where they used to actually line up cars and prepare them for cargo and that kind of thing. We're going to take a look at all the ruins that are here today. As you can see in front of you is an old switching tower, plus a whole bunch of other cool things we're going to look into. So come along with us, and we will take you on a tour of this once bustling area. And who knows what we might find? You'll see it here first on Mr. P Explores. And this building you see before you was the main building of this once busy complex. We're going to take you all the way to the top, walk you all the way down, and see what's inside. There's lots of cool stuff in there. All kinds of railroad equipment, all kinds of stuff, or so we're told. So we'll find out, and you'll get to come with us and see. So let's go see. We are on the top floor of this old switching building, this massive complex. It has 5 levels to it, and here we are at the top. And as you can see out the window here, we've got the entire switching yard. One time this would have held consoles, computers, what have you, to help run the trains, switch things around on the yard. Now if we look out here, see what's left of a little balcony here, which we're not going to attempt to go on because I have no idea whether it'll hold me. So we're going to take you all the way down through this complex, starting with the top level, heading down. This level of the tower actually has what's left of one of the consoles. So this console would have run the switching yard, moving the engines around, that kind of thing. And all the components have probably been stripped. I'm sure all the copper, all the valuable stuff is already gone. Again, out on the roof, we are not going to attempt that because I have no idea what will fall through and what won't. This area here must have been offices or some kind of central operations. Used to be individual offices in here, maybe. No way to really know. Somebody watching this might have worked here at one point. All the paperwork we're seeing leads us to believe that this was in the 80s. This was active still. 86 was the last date I've seen on some time cards laying around. And down there you should be able to see the beautiful Mahoning River, the sun glistening off the water. Thank you. kind of heating element here, some kind of heating system. And you guys can see this right here. There's lots of paperwork laying around, all kinds of stuff from back in the day, just scattered all over the building. Was once the hub of a very large rail yard, and now nothing. Local kids hang out here, as you can see, from all the various graffiti. Some of it less than artistic, some of it less than poetic, but here it is. What you've got here is actually an elevator shaft, which obviously is completely closed down. The elevator is actually at the very bottom. It actually collapsed into the shaft, which we may be able to show you later. These levels are the same towards the bottom, but we'll take you through them anyway, just to be thorough. Make sure you see it all. In fact, here is that elevator shaft I was telling you guys about, and you can look all the way down there. Don't get dizzy. I know I did. And even more dizzy is looking down this old access tunnel of some kind. And a CSX train coming through on the main line here. Like Mothman, but I'm assuming it's a giant mosquito. And if you can see this without the glare, you'll notice there's an old bike that someone tossed into this electrical pole. Some poor kid had to walk home from this place. Who knows what happened to the poor kid's bike? Obviously didn't end well. Cool graffiti here, some of the tiles are painted. We weren't into really good graffiti on these trips, and sadly the graffiti on this trip has not been that fantastic. It's been all right, some of it, and anything that was fantastic has been ruined up by far less artistic people who have a thing for certain body parts. I don't know why. Old phone book right here. All the old fixtures, all the old school fluorescent lighting. Moving on down. Go Renee, May 2007. It's much more open than these lower levels. They may have taken all the load-bearing walls out of here. At one point there might have been walls here, offices, who knows, but as of right now they're all gone. You can see this one right here. It's probably part of a wall. these old lighting fixtures. All the ceiling tiles are coming down, all the acoustic ceiling tiles. We are almost at ground level. Some kind of a fuse box here of some kind. While we've been exploring this place, there's been a dude riding around an ATV. I'm sure the locals use this for their personal racetrack. Crazy, but it still smells like old industrial stuff here. Oil and steel and metal, and railroad kind of stuff. It still has that smell about it. Could be just me. Old switching equipment in there, old electronics. This room actually has the most of that left. And of course, what's left of the old bathroom here, you can still see what's left of the urinals. These guys had to go too, so that's where they went. With a beautiful view of the boxcars outside. I haven't the slightest idea what any of this stuff was used for back in the day. Might have been an old bulletin board where they posted things for the workers that worked here. Maybe they had some kind of window in here at one point, so the boss could check up on everybody working or not working. These almost look like showers. So you might have been showers at one point here. I don't know why the showers would have been on the same level as all the electronics. And as you can see here, all this rubble. Nobody's been showering here for a while. Take a quick pit stop and check out this area up here. There's an area off to the side of the actual switching tower with this giant structure here. It appears to now have water in it. No idea what this is. Some kind of old equipment used to be in here. There's electrical in there somewhere. Something was being pumped through here. Used to be something down here. Something used to be bolted to this. I mean, maybe it was tracks. Now off in that direction, there is some kind of platform with lights. Yeah. and we're heading down to the next level. Getting closer to the bottom here. Apparently, Kristen smells. Words of the poets here in Youngstown. And here we are on the bottom floor. And this is the crazy part. All the old records, all the old time cards, everything in here is from the old facility. No idea why they left it all here, but here it lays. And this must be the poor twin to the bike we saw tossed up in the electrical wires. Some poor kid is without his bike. Wheels are all mangled, but who knows how long it's been here. Is huge. Some kind of garage bay here, maybe for vehicles. A 55-gallon drum of something. And one last area to check out here. Must have been some kind of storage at one point. Maybe records. Alright, now that we're done with the main building, there's all kinds of extra things to check out here. This is awesome tunnel that used to lead underneath some of the tracks of this rail yard. Naturally, we're going to go through it and see what's on the other side. Kinds of extra old railroad ties that were just tossed aside here when they closed the rail yard. Not sure what this used to be. Part of a train car, maybe? Part of a truck? And where we're walking right now used to be rail tracks. There used to be rail tracks here. They've all been taken out. But as we're walking down along the other side of the giant building we just walked through, way up there, you can actually see it in the trees. There were tracks that came back through here. That out. Somebody built a nest in there. So at one point there was a rail line that went through here, for whatever reason. and out the other side and all the way to the main line. You can see the tracks here from the guys riding ATVs. This is probably a pretty popular spot for them to come through. And this structure here, although I'm not totally sure, may have been an engine maintenance bay of some kind, where they pulled the engines in, did maintenance on them, and there go all the birds. But you can see the tracks coming in here, from all the way over there, and all the way into here. And these giant roll doors here at the end of the structure will probably open up and the engines will continue out the other way into the rest of the rail yard. So that's what I'm assuming they are. If you know anything different than that, please let us know in the comments. Up here on our left appears to be what used to be a loading dock of some kind of special loading platform for trains. Nothing totally amazing, but totally worth checking out just for the heck of it. If for nothing in the panoramic view. What used to be the Struthers Yard. All this empty area you see before you used to be rail lines, sidings, probably tons of cars sitting here, all gone now, except for one single train track. And some newly added cell phone towers. The building we're going into now was a smaller tower here that kept track of who was going where in the yard. Not a lot left in here. A lot of graffiti, a lot of damaged stuff. Left of the old bathroom. Anybody gotta go? This is the time to do it. Or not. Bunch of old junk and wiring. And here you've got a bunch of electronics left over. Most of this has probably been gutted by copper salvagers, that kind of thing. Things are starting to kick into fall here. We're getting some really awesome colors with the leaves, starting to anyway. And apparently he is watching. Hopefully you're watching and leaving a nice comment in the comments below. We always welcome that kind of thing. We go on some crazy adventures for you to show you what's out here, out in the world, beyond what you might normally see. So do us a favor and leave us a comment or a like, whatever you feel like doing, whatever feels good to you. Sadly, from what I understand, it's really impossible to get up to the top of that tower there because the steps on the outside are rusted through, and one wrong step and down you go. Me being me, I am not exactly a lightweight, so I don't feel like falling several stories to my death. So we'll try to get up as far as we can. And this is just old electronics. So as you can see, there are some steps missing here. All kinds of shattered glass. Yeah, as you can see here, a lot of this is really rusted, and definitely up on the next level here. We are not going to attempt that because my large mass will fall straight through that and down to the level below, where I will certainly break something or sprain something. And as much as an adventurer as I am, I'm not willing to spend several weeks in a cast or months. But there is one last section of this building to check out. And that telephone pole has seen better days. Looks like the tree has uprooted it and brought it down. Inspector's over. Now we're breaking the rules. And there's not much to see in here. Maybe an old shower stall, perhaps? Hard to say. And the only thing that's really cool about this room is this big red piece of graffiti. So this is going to do it for Mr. P today. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this tour of the old Struthers switching yard here near Youngstown, Ohio. If you enjoyed the video, of course, by all means, like it, follow it, follow the channel, share it on your Facebook page, help us out a little bit, share it with your friends. And as always, as Mr. P is always wont to say, keep on exploring wherever you go and document everything.